check in with the air boss and we'll clear him into the airspace. And I understand he is cleared. If we'll direct your attention to the west, to the right, about 4,000 feet. Prometheus, Skip Stewart, puts it down to the 45 with a roll. There's one, there's two, there's three rolls down on a 45, picking up his airspeed. And let's see if I can keep up with Skip today. Pull to those up, there's okay, there we go. That roller inverted an outside snap roll across the horizon. There it is, the airplane tries to tumble end over end with the outside rudder. You'll hear the noise that airplanes make, and that's the propeller going transonic on the tips as it cavitates. Three blades, it's a composite propeller. Wooden core with composites on the outside. There's two. There's three outside snaps down on a 45 on a half a cubic inch. Pulls it out just over the water right there. Yep, there's material. Pulls it back to pass through. Okay, two vertical. There's a quarter. There's two-thirds of a roll. Up to the top. As the aircraft comes to a stop hanging on the propeller, he'll kick in left rudder. And he'll hold it there for a nice pinwheel as the aircraft turns all the way out around the wingtip two times. Back down on a 45 with recovery just over the water at about 50 feet. Back to inverted, past vertical. On top there's one, two, three snap rolls on top of a loop for the triple avalanche. And he likes to check that water real close when he just gets right down there and puts the wheels on the water. Back to the vertical with two snap rolls on the vertical line. Brings it to a stop at the top, hanging on the propeller. And he lets it just flip right over the top, and he's continuing to let the torque on that propeller roll that aircraft around the crankshaft. Now he's using his controls to make that happen for three outside snap rolls on the down line on the 45. Right back to just over the water, Skip Stewart and Prometheus. 200 plus miles an hour right off the end of the pier. Back to vertical with an outside snap, straight up, there's three of them. And he's flat on top, coming back down, straight down towards the water to the Gulf of Mexico. Pulls the stick back for about 5 G's as he recovers. And back up on a 45. One aileron roll up and with an outside snap one direction and an outside snap the other. He's really working today. Back up on the 45, he'll pull the stick back and bring the airplane back to show center. Four snap rolls up on a 45. You can hear that propeller really ripping through the air. The propeller, the tips going transonic, if you can imagine the force of the tips of that propeller blade like cutting through concrete. The air is compressed so hard on the end of that propeller. It's just amazing. All that noise you're hearing with that propeller. Coming back down on a 45, inverted, pushes the stick forward for recovery. About 50 feet above the Gulf of Mexico, pushes the stick forward again and really pushing those negative G's, about a negative 3.5, almost 4 G's on that recovery. You pull the stick back for a high-speed stall right there and a micro loop. And he's back down and he's still got the wing stalled, as you can see, barely flying. Hopefully here in a minute he'll push the stick forward and get the wing flying. Right now it's pure prop blast holding that aircraft in the air. It is not flying, it is just hanging on the propeller right now. The crankshaft really working hard for you. Back down on a 45, got the wing flying again, picking up his airspeed right off the end of the pier. Well, actually he's at about, yep, 1,500 feet from show line. Up on a 45, the half roll vertical. Back down on a 45, half cubic eight, there's a half a roll down on the cover. And there's his knife edge climbing on a 45 with an outside snap, back to knife edge up on a 45. Very talented pilot here today. You have to understand those snap rolls, what they basically are horizontal spins. He is spinning that aircraft when it's going across the sky. When you see a snap roll going straight up, he is making the aircraft spin going straight up. Usually you think of a spin as coming down to earth. He's making the aircraft spin as it's going straight up. Really working for you today. You're watching the pilot who is the actual first pilot to ever fly an airplane under a jumping motorcycle at an air show. Done all kind of neat stuff. He's actually driven the world's fastest Dodge Ram jet truck. Back to vertical. And there's your half aileron roll. He's spinning it straight up again with a snap roll to vertical. Right up to the top. The aircraft hanging on the propellers is hanging there. Watch it as it continues to torque roll around the crankshaft for one, two, about three lengths of the aircraft, closer to four lengths of the aircraft, flying backwards over Pensacola Beach. Back up to about 220 miles an hour. At the end, there's your knife out on the outside, snap back to up 45 on the knife edge as it tips the left rudder end to slide the aircraft around, and it looks like you may be getting ready to pull something out of the sled. If I can address your attention out halfway over or halfway down the pier, you'll see two poles and you'll see an orange ribbon stretched between them. Watch that ribbon as Skip Stewart lines up for that ribbon. Right now, he's lined up. He's got it lined up. He's going to cut that ribbon. He's below the pier. Hopefully, he'll come up. And he's just going to take a look at that ribbon and say, hey, okay, everything looks good. We're going to get the chance to witness the first ribbon cut on Pensacola Beach Pier. And he's rolled upside down. Ladies and gentlemen, direct your attention to show center Skip Stewart, Prometheus, inverted over Pensacola Beach as he cuts the ribbon. Very nice. And an outside, 1.5 outside snap. Back up to 40 horsepower. Big three-bladed truck. Making a lot of noise, a lot of smoke. Climb rate 4,000 feet a minute. Just level speed, full throttle, close to 200 miles an hour. And here we go, up on the knife edge. Skip Stewart hanging that airplane on the prop as he eases it over the pier. Pulls the bag, you can hear the propeller cavitating just to keep that aircraft barely over the water, just hanging that aircraft on the prop. If you'll notice, the wings are not flying that aircraft. It is all prop blast, and he's using the side of the fuselage to let that aircraft just skid across Pensacola Beach. And we've got a rolling turn, a rolling 180. So far, let's see if he can bring it all the way around to 360. He may just say, you know, 180 is enough. I can tell you that's probably one of the most difficult maneuvers he's doing today is the rolling turn. The aircraft is rolling around its longitudinal axis as it makes a turn through the air. A lot of folks get together to make that aircraft possible. I'd like to say thanks to Pensacola's own Blue Angel Aviation. They're keeping all the radios functioning properly in that aircraft. Also, like to say thanks to Superflight for the cover on the airframe.
Very few aircraft have more thrust than weight as far as a propeller-driven aircraft. You'll see that in Sukhois from time to time. Some of the Yak-55s will achieve that, but this is an aircraft of Skip's design. And he will roll that aircraft longitudinally as he gains his airspeed to get the aircraft flying again. Not one moment that aircraft is just taking it easy. He works that aircraft. From the time he enters that air show box here, if you can just take your hat off and wave to him, let him know how much you appreciate
it. And he was working his heart out for you today here at Pensacola Beach. We're proud to have him back. He was here last year, proud to have him back this year, and he's just excited. He was here for many years. I don't know if he calls Pensacola his home or not, but I know he was here long enough we can say he's a hometown boy.